In this section, we're going to be covering the corner tool, and I have a few objects on screen that we're going to test it out on. So starting with the first one, this yellow square here, I'm going to zoom in so we can have a closer look. So it's currently selected, and if I go over to the tools panel on the left-hand side, there's the corner tool. You can click on that or press C on the keyboard. That's your shortcut. So what we notice is in the context toolbar, it says corner type and everything is grayed out. The only thing I can click is bake appearance, and I don't want to do that just yet. So if we go ahead and look at our shape, we can see the nodes are active now. But if we look in the layers panel, it still says rectangle. So remember before, you can use a shape and it is a rectangle, but then you can convert it to curves so you can see those nodes and further customize it. So as soon as I went into the corner tool, it's showing me the node. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to select this corner here. And look, as I hover over the node, you can see a little icon. That means it's the corner tool. I can click and drag. And my finger is held down. And if you look at the context toolbar, those corner types are no longer grayed out. And there's a radius, which is telling me how many pixels, I guess, this corner is. So I want you now, before I let go of my finger, look at the layers panel. It currently says rectangle under the yellow square. When I let go, it turns into a curve. So it's basically like converting to curves when I do this action. So what if I made a mistake and I want to continue playing around with this corner? Well, I'd head on over to the corner tool again, click on that, and now you can see the handle is there. So you see this red little circle? That is our handle. So I can click that and I can drag it in and out. And we can look at the top and you can see there's different corner types. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to head on over to the top right node and I'm going to click and drag that in, and now I'm going to choose a different corner type. So this first one is none. That basically will make it back to how it was, which is a pointy corner. I can click this one, which is a round corner, but we're going to go for this option, straight. So now we have a straight edge, we can pull it in and out. Excellent. Let's move on to the next one, bottom right node. Let's use concave and look what that does. So there's our concave option, and the last one we'll just do it to complete it. Click and drag, and basically that one is called cutout. So the only other thing up here, apart from this radius, which you can enter in manually or drag this up and down, the only other thing here is bake appearance. And I'm not going to click that just yet. That's going to convert it to curves like we've done previously. What I'm going to do is I'm going to hit the move tool, and I'm going to show you what happens if you scale down and scale up. So right now I'm going to hold shift and command and just click from a corner and scale down. You can see it's not kind of retaining its original look as I scale down. And if you don't want that, this is where bake appearance comes in, or convert to curves. So with the move tool selected, we can see up here in the context toolbar, I can click convert to curves. But because we're in the corner tool tutorial, I'm going to go over to the corner tool, click on that. And you see here, it says bake appearance. Basically, that is exactly the same thing. It's just going to bake in that look. It's going to convert everything I've done into curves. So I'll go ahead and click on it. So now that I've clicked on it, I can no longer see those handles, and everything is just nodes, isn't it? So now let's go ahead and click on the move tool again and scale it down. So click and drag down, and you can see it's retaining its style. Okay, let's move over to this other square that I've created. Still a rectangle because I used the rectangle tool. And what I'm going to show you here is basically selecting multiple nodes to apply this effect. So I'm going to go over to the corner tool, click on it, and this time I'm going to click and drag over these two nodes, and I'm going to click and drag down on one of them. And you see it affects both of them. And of course, you can go back to the corner tool and choose your different types of corner. So I'll just leave it on that for now. Also, I just want to give you a little bit of a hand now, although we're going to go into this a bit later, is selecting nodes that aren't right next to each other. So let me demonstrate. So Command Z to go back. Okay, we're back to our original square. I'm going to select the corner tool again. And let's say I want to select this node on the bottom right and this node up here on the top left. So as this node is selected, I can hold down shift and I can go over to whatever other node I want and select that as well. Now I can let go. So top left and bottom right are selected. And now I could just go to the corner tool, which is selected already, and just drag like this. So that's one way of selecting them. I will get into this further later, but if I just deselect that and I'll go back to the corner tool, I will just show you how to select in a different way. So if you just hold down Option or Alt on your keyboard, click and drag, and see, like, I can draw now. So I can draw down here, get that one, and that's it. So by using that shortcut, I can select nodes that are maybe in difficult places. Okay, let's move on and actually do it on something that looks like a glass. It's very simple, I know. But basically, here is what I want to show you. You can use this corner tool on multiple different objects. So we've got this object here, and we've got this object here. So I'm just going to select both of them. So you can either do this like I did it before. So I've selected the blue part, and now I'll select the drink part by holding shift. By the way, you can do this from the layers panel as well. So if we go down, I haven't labeled them, I should have done really. This is our drink, this is our kind of glass part. So I can select one of them, hold down command and click. By the way, if you're selecting more than that, you can just hold down shift, and let's say you go down to here and just click on the last one. But if you're selecting individual ones, you just hold down command. Maybe you want to select that. You see how it works. So anyway, I'm selecting both of them. Now I'm going to click on C on the keyboard. That's our corner tool. Now I'm just going to select all of those nodes down here, and I'm going to drag it up like that, just because I want a smooth corner there. And I'm going to let go. So right now I can see that this corner didn't really work so well. Not sure why, but I can just play around with that one. So I'll just click off, and I'll click on again just to the drink. Select this node, and I'll drag the handle out a little bit more so it looks a little bit more even. And maybe this one a little bit more as well. There we go. I'm happy with that. So you can use the corner tool on multiple different objects. Let's do one more example of that with a lot more objects. So here I have a bunch of triangles, basically. They're not connected. What I'm going to do is just select all of them. I'm going to hit C for the corner tool. I'm going to click and select all of these top ones, and I'm going to drag it down like this. Okay, great. But what if I wanted to make this little section smooth as well? Well, that's where something else comes in, and that's called Boolean operations, where you can add together multiple shapes. And this is what the next section is about. So here's just a little taster. So I'm just going to press Command Z to go back. So they're all individual ones. I can go ahead and select them all, and I'm going to go up to Boolean operations, and I'm going to click on Add. Now you can see in the Layers panel that it's just one layer, and I can just drag that one layer around. So it's all just one now. We'll get into this in the next section, but now we're going to use the Corner tool. So I'm going to press C on the keyboard, and I'm going to select all of these nodes at the top here. Now I'm just going to click on any of these nodes and click and drag. And you can see how it works on all of these nodes and produces this really nice smooth wavy pattern. And if I really like this, I can go ahead and click on Bake Appearance, and there we go. Moving on to the next section. Oh, actually, there's one more thing that I almost completely forgot to tell you. So if you just go ahead and grab your rectangle tool and just draw one out, basically you can use the corner tool from here without even entering the corner tool. So if we look in the context toolbar, remember it always helps us out this bit. It says corner, and of course I showed you this earlier where you can just choose the corner type, straight, etc. So we'll just keep it on rounded. You can also head over to here. You see it says single radius? If I uncheck that, it gives me all of these other options. And basically, TL means top left, so it'd be this section. TR, top right, and you get it. So I could do in each individual corner separately. So here I can just do maybe a little bit. On the top right, I can do maybe a lot more. So just so you know, you can actually do some of these actions within the shape because they're quite smart. Okay, now we can move on.